You know, ladies, I've come to realize that there is a time to look back and remember, and there's a time to pivot around and look forward. Specifically, it's wise to look back and remember at how God has intersected with your life in the past and answered prayer. And it's wise to actually even write those things down, those answers to prayer, those God sightings. I like to call them God sightings, where God orchestrates something in your life or answers a prayer, or you could just tell that God showed up in some way in your life. I like to write those things down. I'm not a huge journaler, but I try to just write a quick little note down every time I see something like that happen, so that when I need to have my faith built once again, when I'm facing a challenge, I can look back and go, that's right. I remember that God showed up and did that and did that and answered that prayer. And okay, so what am I worried about? I can trust in the Lord. So that's when it's wise to look back. But there are some dangers in looking back in other ways. There are just pitfalls involved in looking back in two specific ways. One of them is to maybe just check up on how that old high school boyfriend is doing. I mean, what's the harm after all? I mean, you know, you've been married for 10 years or even 30 years, and it's like, what does it really matter if you're just curious? You're just curious. I wonder whatever happened to so-and-so. There are so many marriages that are destroyed through people reconnecting on Facebook with old flames. Danger, danger ahead, right? So just be wise. There's no real good reason to want to reconnect and look back at old flames, old boyfriends, old husbands if you're divorced and remarried. Just leave the past in the past. But a second way that it's really dangerous to look back is when you continue reminding yourself of your husband's past failures. How's that working for you? And yet, for some reason, we sometimes neurotically replay over and over again the things that our husband has done wrong in the past. And boy, can we remember every single detail, like what we were wearing, what time it was when this happened, whatever. I mean, we just are really good at remembering those things, right? And looking back, and oh yeah, and then we get all upset all over again, and the resentment just keeps building and building and building. And how is that working for you? Probably not so well. How about if we leave the past failures of our husband and others in our lives in the past, where they belong? In fact, Paul says this in Philippians 3, forgetting what is behind and straining toward what is ahead, I press on toward the goal. Maybe that's what we all need to do. Now, if your husband is currently sinning against you, or anyone is currently sinning against you, yes, you need to confront that. You need to draw boundaries. You can read Matthew 18, verses 15 through 17, where Jesus instructs you what to do if someone's sinning against you in the here and now. But if it's something from the past, let's just leave it in the past so that resentment does not choke out that relationship today.